Addiction is a disease. But what does that actually mean? First, it's important to understand how our brain's reward center works. When we eat, drink water, or are intimate, our brain releases dopamine, a chemical that says, "Let's do that again." This is important for our survival because we are rewarded for doing things that keep our bodies alive and healthy. There are other activities that cause dopamine to be released as well, like exercising or playing video games. Your brain prioritizes activities which are most important to survival. The activities that produce more dopamine, like eating, are going to take priority over others. Now consider alcohol or other drugs. These substances also cause a dopamine release, oftentimes in much greater amounts than survival-based activities. So your brain is fooled into thinking that these substances are necessary. So when does alcohol or other drug use cross over from recreational to addiction? When someone's ability to achieve their goals is affected by drug use, such as by creating problems at home or work, or developing physical side effects, addiction is likely the cause. So why don't people just stop? Because addiction is a disease. In 1956, the American Medical Association declared that alcoholism was an illness. In 1991, they announced that alcoholism would now be classified as both a psychiatric and medical condition. The criteria to identify as a disease is that it must be biological in nature, is not caused by someone's actions, has observable signs or symptoms, has a predictable timeline of its development and recovery, and treatment impacts the recovery. Addiction is a chronic disease, much like diabetes or hypertension, with symptoms that have to be controlled over a lifetime. Just like with those diseases, genetics can play a big role in addiction. If one parent has addiction, their children are 6 times more likely to be addicted. But addiction is complicated. Factors like biology and altered brain functioning play a role. So does psychology, such as negative emotions, including stress and anxiety, and even social and environmental factors like family, peers, and culture can all contribute to the complexity of how addiction is experienced differently for some rather than others. What are the signs of addiction? Symptoms of addiction can be seen both behaviorally and physically. Behavioral signs and symptoms can include changes to a person's daily activities, relationships, goals, or motivation. Physical signs and symptoms also focus on changes, such as changes in weight, skin appearance, sleep patterns, or energy levels. Why don't people get treatment when they're addicted? People may not realize that they are addicted. It's the brain's dysfunction that undermines the ability to recognize and do something about addiction. Or, if they do realize it, they may not want to stop or seek treatment due to how they have rationalized their use, the fear of detox, feelings of shame or stigma, or even the logistics of cost or time away from work and family. People who are addicted are good people with a bad, chronic disease. Remember that no one chooses to be an addict or an alcoholic. It's not a moral failing, and it's not about lack of will. Addiction is a physical, psychological, and spiritual disease that knows no boundaries and can affect anyone. Do you or someone you love need help? Reach out today. You're worth it.